Hey guys, welcome to a Grizzled Beagle playthrough. This is Kreslev.
This is Dookie Dingo.
And this is Jotsam.
Today we're doing Suicide Blitz 2. It is a user-created campaign that requires suicide and blitzing, but not necessarily in that order.
It reminds me of that scene from Day and Night with Tom Cruise, where he goes, "Nobody follow us, or I'll kill myself and then the girl."
I don't think would work.
Thank you. Thank you for the joke. That was... That's fantastic.
I'd like to explain.
So,
please.
Is Suicide Blitz like a ballroom blitz?
No, this is like a football blitz.
Ballroom blitz.
As you can see, this zombie's ticket actually has the survivors and the zombies on there. It sounds like people actually knew the zombie apocalypse was happening and were trying to sell tickets to it.
So that
really
zombie
love the
be
fact
scalping
that this guy,
tickets?
I really love that this guy was so excited about going to this one game that he didn't even realize he was being eaten. Like, he was just holding on to his ticket the whole time. He's just sitting there staring at it like, "Oh, I cannot wait. Ow, what's hurt? What's happening? Why is this hurt?"
More than likely, he was scalping the ticket. And then they scalped him back.
Yeah, nobody actually goes to games anymore. All they do is just scalp. Everybody buys tickets and then sells them to other people, like, who then turn around and hope that they can sell them again.
Seriously, if you've been to a football game lately, it's... you have to wade through the scalpers.
"Hey man, you need a ticket?" "Nah bro, I'm good. First ticket's free." I'm good. I'm alright. Golf club or wrench? Golf club or wrench?
Oh, too late. I got the golf club.
I'm gonna do...
I'm actually going pistols.
Yeah, let's pistol it up.
Pistol... since somebody took the other pistol.
I didn't take the other pistol.
That would be me. I got it.
I got the golf club.
There's a wrench. There's a wrench in there if you want that.
We'll put a wrench in the zombies' plans.
Frying pan.
Be right back. I'm muting Jotsam.
Hey guys. News Chopper 5. You're here.
Where is it?
It's over here.
Down there in the...
It's magically floating in the side of the building.
Largely undamaged. News Chopper 5, truly the safest of all safe rooms.
Yeah, for some reason we abandon it whenever we find it.
Well, I mean, it's fine. It'll be okay.
By the way,
well,
guys...
Yeah, we'll find it again.
Guys, the elevator's not working.
You know, the News Chopper 5 is like Yoshi from Super Mario World. It seems like he just died horribly, but eventually you just find him again.
Hey, Dingo. Dingo.
Hold on, I'm backed up into a corner with dead men.
There's some nice music playing in the elevator.
And I'll carry it with me like my father did. Doo-doo-doo-doo.
Strangely calming.
Yeah, except for the Boomer screams of the undead. Oh, guys, I don't think this is our floor. This is
I do like this window in the back that shows, you know, cityscape, cityscape, cinder block, cinder block, cinder block, cityscape, cinder block. It's very pretty.
Who puts windows in an elevator anyway?
There's a lot of elevators.
I think that's probably against OSHA.
Restore power to the elevator.
I think it was just a drunk architect. Okay, it stopped.
Architect,
let's
go home. You're drunk.
Back on. But the windows in the elevator.
So, Jim, do you have those plans for the elevator? Yeah. Just give
look,
me
all the vents have arches.
People think it's McDonald's and they'll all be in here. It'll make us a ton of money. I'm jockeyed, by the way.
No,
thank you.
Not.
Well, I was more jockeyed than not jockeyed at that particular point in time.
Alright, I got it shut off.
What is happening?
Stuff and things. Jeez, get with the program.
All right, Rick.
Who's Rick?
From The Walking Dead. I got stuff and things to do.
Does he actually say that? I stopped watching it because he bored me.
Hey guys,
right, back to the elevator.
The building is shaking.
Oh, it's fine. It'll be fine. It's okay.
Bye, Rochelle.
You know, I actually did stop watching The Walking Dead because of Rick Grimes. Can you imagine him not breathing heavily? Because I can't. Every line. Every
zombies are floating.
Line.
Zombies are floating. Floating zombies.
That would make Rick Grimes breathe heavily.
Hey guys, the top of the elevator's open.
Shame, I got stuff and things to do.
Spitter.
Yes, thank you. I honestly, I mean, I still watch it, but my big problem wasn't Rick Grimes. It was Lori.
Oh, she's dead. Spoiler.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hopefully, no one. Everyone's watching made it through that season.
Yeah, but you always have to say spoiler after you say something, just so that people know it was a spoiler.
Spoilers.
Spoiler alert: in The Walking Dead, a lot of people are dead. Like a lot. Like most of the
and
planet.
And now, I'm muting.
Wait, have y'all got to the part where the unicorns are yet?
The unicorns. Oh. Kreslev, you can't tell people about that. Reloading! Spoiler alert, there's your name. Wow, I feel like a jerk now.
It's alright, I'm gonna cut it out.
Alright, so at this particular point, the survivors have been together for a long time.
Mm-hmm. We've all copulated at this point.
Oh, Lord. thank you for putting that image in my head. Sometimes a coach gets lonely.
Spoiler alert. Rochelle's not involved nearly as much as you might think.
Well, she's only a fourth of the entire group, so I mean... Yeah. I just killed that hunter by slicing open his buttocks. That was interesting. Alright, anyway, point I was trying to make, though, was they've been together for a really long time, right? I mean, they've pretty much talked about everything, and you can only be scared for so long. So at what point did they just start talking normally while this whole apocalypse thing was going on? Like, all these people are around him trying to kill him and everything. And they just start talking about the same stuff that we're talking about. You know, I mean, at what point... Oh, Rochelle's getting smoked, by the way. Hey,
let me put it to you this way. After the first time you see Coach naked, you're just not scared of anything anymore. Yeah, the first time he says, hey, put on this football helmet, and that's pretty much it.
I think you're making some insinuations there about Coach's sexuality I'm not entirely comfortable with. Reloading here! Reloading! But, I mean, do you think that as this is going on, do you think they're starting to argue about what their favorite movie is?
I know I would be.
Well, I mean, look at that regardless.
Now, if you think back, though, the first time I ever played Left 4 Dead, which, goodness knows, it's been a very long time ago, and granted, I was young.
I'm hunted.
I was very young. But I actually thought the game was scary.
He was actually a baby. He was actually a baby. Like a legitimate baby. Goo goo gaga, kill zombie. Like, yeah, that was pretty much it.
Hey, guys, this guy has lotto tickets. This guy has lotto tickets. I have to get in there.
And I want to remind you that I am the one who introduced all of you to Left 4 Dead, so
take that.
Congratulations.
Yes.
Does that make you like alpha nerd, or how does that work?
No, because I also introduced all of you to Borderlands and pretty much everything you've ever loved.
You did not introduce me to my wife.
This is a different kind of love. That's a passable.
Says you.
I knew Jotsam's wife before he did.
That's true. That is true.
Information that doesn't necessarily help anyone.
I think it's pretty much the. I'm pretty sure it's the same. It's the same type of love. I always like to be in a dark room with a closed door. I like
that's
to push
not
buttons.
Love.
Well, if that's not love, I don't know what is.
Push buttons. Yeah. What kind of wife do you have again? Is this like
a
real human? Okay.
Beep loop, what is love?
What is love? Baby, don't
hurt
me.
I was about to say, oh. How realistic is the sex doll, or have you actually married a person?
Oh, robot wife, you're the only one who understands me.
Affirmative.
Please insert disc 2 of emotions.
Philip J. Fry, that's what I always think of. But...
I gotta be honest, the first time I ever heard that, I thought she was saying feel up Philip J. Fry.
No, it's I'd forgotten his name.
I'd forgotten his name was Philip. Hey, I just assumed his name was Fry J. Fry.
Bye, Rochelle.
It's okay, she'll come back with 50% health. It's perfect. It's the perfect crime.
What are you guys doing in here? Healing. Stop touching things.
No, oh, thank God I got help back.
I'm in here touching your things, spoiling your names.
You know, it's kind of interesting that there's always 4 medkits in every safe room. What if you went in there and there were 3 medkits and another one that was a little bit icky, had some zombie guts on it? Does that still count?
Dibs on that one. It's probably still warm.
We all know what Dingo likes to do with medkits.
Push their buttons. Beep.
Beep boop. What is love?
Here you go.
Please insert hard drive.
Here you go, Dingo.
Waka waka. What? What? What are we doing?
Oh, you're not in the game yet. There you go.
Yeah, I'm
Dingo,
right here.
Over here. Found a picture of your wife.
Wait, what? Is it the bunny?
Over here.
Oh, I can't believe you just did that. The humans are dead. Beep boop. What is love?
The humans are dead. Anybody get the Flight of the Conchords reference?
Yeah, there? I was about to say, it's Flight of the Conchords reference, man.
Yeah.
There are no more unethical treatment of elephants.
Technically true.
You can't treat an elephant unethically. It's just not possible.
I bet I could.
Well, we know what you do in dark rooms.
Actually, I haven't said anything. You're the one who's revealed that kind of information.
Don't kink shame.
That was a really
long
truck.
No, that is also not becoming. That is not becoming a.
That's a catchphrase.
It's not a catchphrase.
Hey,
it's not a catchphrase.
Goodness. You are mowing through the catchphrase train.
Is that your catchphrase?
I don't know. It doesn't really make much sense if you think about it.
You are mowing through the catchphrase train. Choo-choo, baby.
I don't know many people who mow trains, but...
You have to have a special
You have not lived, sir.
Reload.
I have never traveled by train.
Never traveled by
I'm gonna call shenanigans on that one.
Like,
you've been to, No, he's been to, Oh, there's a witch around here. I don't know what she is.
I saw the witch. How did I start the witch? What was the witch?
She found your collection of questionable music taste.
It's a hipster. That's what witches are.
She was extremely startled.
She came over to tell you that their early stuff was better.
Is this Fly of the Conchords? Why are you listening to this?
Get out of here. Get this out of here. This is trash. This is garbage. Taste my fingernails. What? Why? Did you wash your hands? This is horrible. Beep boop. What is love? All right,
what were you
on.
Saying about trains? What was... I'm trying to figure out what that was.
You've never traveled by rail?
Yeah, I've traveled by metro, but that's stupid. That's not the real thing.
Why did you throw a British accent on that?
It's a way of emphasizing stupid. Also, the majority of the rail riding I have done was in London.
Oh, now he's been to London.
But did you mind the gap?
I did mind that
mind
gap.
The gap.
Sometimes I would just sit there for 20 minutes and just mind it.
Did you get any good loot?
I did not.
It's all about the loot.
Ooh, sniper.
That's what Left 4 Dead's really missing. Loot.
You're thinking about Borderlands again.
How much more people would explore unnecessary areas if there was loot?
But it would definitely be more of a risk-reward scenario.
They already try to search for weapons that aren't there.
Yeah, they're not even there, and they're already doing it. I really wouldn't worry about it.
We have not been talking about this mod at all.
Oh, are we playing something?
Yeah, are we playing a game?
I was doing my laundry.
Okay, this is kind of an interesting gimmick. All right, so there is a boat down there. and is moored, and they figured out the only way to unmoor the boat is to set off that gas can that's going to burn the mooring rope to allow the boat to drift right here.
What's this, a Rube Goldberg machine?
It's a terrible plan. Well, I can understand them, like, letting it go.
Jotsam, quit that.
Hey, I was going to shoot the gas can and you shot it, and I'm going to shoot something.
Wait, there's fireworks over there? When did that happen?
Well, that was a,
Charger coming over the fence.
Oh, I'm hunted.
If only we cared.
Ouch.
And nothing of value is lost.
Jotsam is going.
I killed the boomer.
Time is going on. I'm starting to feel like, you're starting to become a little more antagonistic towards me. Oh, a jockey.
Antagonistic?
I can't see anything. Where are you jockeyed at?
I'm sorry, you came at me with saying I'd been on a train before, and
you
if
have.
That's not antagonistic.
I'm failing to see how accusing someone of riding a train at some point in their life is considered antagonistic.
It is. You know I'm prejudiced against trains.
Those dirty, dirty trains.
Ah, jeez, I'm in spitter goo.
What? I am about to go down, and this is not good. And I'm down. Rochelle, do you need to lift me up whenever you're right in the direct line of fire for me killing things?
Oh. Oh, it's here.
How did Rochelle
bye, Rochelle.
Die?
Did she die?
Jurassic Park, shoddy. Yeah, she's dead.
And when I say I didn't care if you were dying, it was really just referring to your avatar.
Oh, I don't
if
care
you
if everybody
actually...
dies either. Okay, hold on, time out. Do not shoot the windows.
Look, here's a peace offering. No, I'm kidding.
Man.
No.
Oh,
no. I give it.
I was happy and then disappointed and then happy all over again. Like, I ran through an entire gambit of emotions in about 16 seconds.
Wait,
it was great.
That's what a good film does.
Did he
does.
Throw cards at you?
Gambit. Sorry, gambit. Gambit of emotions, not gambit. I misspoke. I was trying to... I said don't shoot the windows!
It wasn't me.
There was zombies standing in front of the windows. I have a shotgun.
Leave the person who turns on the alarm.
I'm being hunted. No, I'm being smoked. I'm having things touch me. This is not good.
Don't touch me there.
One of them was noodly and wet.
I didn't mind that one so much.
I'm assuming the smoker's tongue is wet. It actually doesn't look wet. It looks really dry and ropey.
He has a dry cough. It's a dry cough. That's what it is.
That's really what the smoker's trying to do, is just smoke you so they can moisten his tongue.
That is tank.
He's like, lick this, lick this. Boy, there's a lot of infected. Oh, look at this.
There's also a tank. Yeah, I tried to tell you. There was a tank.
I assumed he was over there with you guys. I got kind of lost around this beautiful hearth.
This is some high quality masonry.
Stop that tank. That is not nice.
This is just proof you can't stop to appreciate anything in the zombie apocalypse. I ain't
leaving you, but you better get up.
Kreslev has rescued me.
I was coming. I was the one who set the tank on fire.
The tank's real weakness, tables.
Well, he's too courteous to move the tables. So he has to go around all of them. I think that tank may have been a waiter. I got a pipe
bomb. If I move this, I just have to put it right back.
I always feel really bad about moving restaurant tables in the restaurant.
I don't
know about anybody else.
I move the tables and I stare at them right in the eyes. I do it.
Well, you know they've got to move them back.
Oh, absolutely. That's why I stare at them right in the eye.
But my wife made me do it a couple of weeks ago, and I just felt so guilty.
Oh, we really need some health.
Yeah, we're not doing great, but it's okay. If one of you die, I could use a bit. I have a defib. Anyway. Ow. Hello, Charger. Alright, so anyway, the point I was trying to make here a long time ago was that they have to have been talking about just stuff.
Oh, jeez, Boomer. Sorry, we'll pick this up after the Boomer. Which is kind of like a commercial break.
And we'll be right back after this puking fat man.
He's just crouching.
Well, think about it. It changes what you see, and you feel icky afterwards.
What are you doing, buddy?
Oh. He's dead. That's what he's doing. He's
hey, bud.
Dead.
What you doing? Where are we going? Oh.
I don't know. I'm actually turned around. Is it this way?
I'm slow.
I suppose so.
And in temporary health.
Why are you talking like Mitch McConnell? Does being injured make you talk like Mitch McConnell?
Oh, look, guys. A safe room door has been knocked down, meaning this room wasn't so safe after all. What a new and innovative cliche.
A new and innovative cliche.
Yeah, well, I mean, it really is. It's so...
That is called a play on words for our viewers who are unfamiliar with it.
What... How much of a life do you not have if you're the person who has to review reviews? Oh, that was... Yeah. I was
that
chopping
boomer.
At the
you
charger
chopped.
And the boomer... Yeah, I was chopping at the charger and the boomer stepped in.
I want to play.
Hey, guys. Hey, guys, what's going on? And oh, God, a machete.
Yeah, boomers just want to be friends.
Hey,
they
wait.
Can't help it. They're about to pop.
Is this the tunnel from... Half-Life 2?
All fat people just want a hug. That is a scientific fact.
This is the tunnel from Half-Life 2.
Good.
Are there antlions?
Hopefully. I hope there's antlions.
Oh, jeez, I hate those.
What? Antlions are the best once you get the little... Oh, no, that's spoilers. Never mind.
Yeah, let's not ruin the game that's over 10 years old.
There may be one person in the entirety of the world who has never played Half-Life 2, but they do in fact watch this video. And I will not be held accountable.
Hey, this was a valley.
I'm going to confess that with all video games, I much prefer killing people to animals. And I'm not sure entirely what that is, I just find it more fun.
Oh, I
think that's because animals don't have the propensity for evil.
Says you. I don't know how many skags
killed. On Borderlands, yeah, I prefer killing bandits to skags. I just think it's more fun.
That's because skags are adorable.
Well, yeah, they're just so sweet.
I'll let you guys heal.
Let me heal. Let me heal. All
right. Dude, we just got our asses handed to us. Okay, well that was fun. Can we please go back to the point I was making? Like, from the very beginning.
What
do you think the survivors are...
A great
what do you
point.
Think the survivors are talking about? They,
we can
they
hear
run
them.
Out of things, I know, but in their downtime...
Well, Ellis is obviously telling stories.
About his buddy
Chief. But everybody's sick of his crap. Nobody wants to listen to him. Oh, and then you immediately jump in and shoot. Okay. Sorry,
maybe
first thing I saw as we jumped in was Rochelle shooting Ellis.
Well, maybe that's what they talk about, is killing Ellis. Just for hours, they talk about killing Ellis.
Alright, so this is weird. Alright, so what they did was they put, since this is the bottom of a police station, they put crates full of Tonfas. And that's cool and all, and it makes sense, but I have a mod that turns the Tonfa into a giant wrench, and so there's just like six huge wrenches just laying on the ground,
I'm
which makes
I'm gonna
a whole
call,
lot less
I'm
sense.
I'm going to call BS. They're not going to have crates full of Tonfas.
How do you know? Have you ever been a police officer?
I've been a government worker, and I can tell you now that no one has that kind of funding.
Let's get ready.
But they do have crates of wrenches. The problem is the crates of wrenches are closed with bolts.
I really wish I had a giant wrench to open this enormous bolt with. I can't get in. I can't get to these wrenches. It'd be even worse if there was like a window in the box that you could see that there were giant wrenches in there, but you couldn't get through.
Yeah, and on the glass it says, the glass of the window, it says, please break glass with wrench.
In the event, please only break glass with wrench. In the event of an emergency, please use wrench.
Whoa, I need
We went the wrong way.
Yeah, I am in a place, and things are smashing me, and this is like being at Walmart on Black Friday.
I forgot that we're supposed to go through the commissary or whatever this is, the lunchroom.
Commissary?
Are you German? He's
defect?
German.
I hope.
A commissary is a store.
Well, I mean, this is where it would be if it would be anywhere, right?
This looks more like a dining facility or a defect.
but they do have commissaries in prisons. I mean, how else do they buy, you know, stuff?
like shivs and wine.
Shivs. You can the sangria you can make in the toilet. Nobody killed that hunter.
You can make the shiv in the toilet too. Trust me.
You can make a shiv in a toilet. Come on, man. Of course, it's sangria or be sangria.
No, it's cool, Smoker. You can take 3 shotguns to the face. That's awesome.
I'm going to die. I don't want to die.
Oh.
You don't, no, Chris. We really have low health. Stop hitting me with that med kit.
I'm trying to help you. Let me heal your face by smashing it over and over.
Well, I assumed you were trying to heal me until about the third or fourth swipe.
Bye, tank. Oh
crap,
god, that didn't go as planned at all.
The door was too narrow. I just killed Rochelle. Pretty sure.
Close the doors. Close
Where
the doors.
Where in the heck are we supposed to be going?
Oh, this way, quickly.
Medkits.
Sweet medkits.
I don't
melee
have
weapon.
One.
Did anybody set that tank on fire, or should we just be?
No,
running?
He's,
that
on, was he's me. On fire. Just keep.
Yeah, he's on.
Okay.
He's definitely
he's
on a lot of fire.
He's here.
Ow. Stand. Oh yeah, he's here and he's mad.
Where Stand he behind else? The CRT monitors. They are indestructible.
Why did I go outside where there's police cars?
Where is Dingo?
Oh, no.
Yeah,
I'm
why
outside.
Did you go out here? He's dead. I killed him with like one shot. You guys suck.
He wasn't that hard.
My bullets were hitting him harder.
Let's get you back up on your feet. Thanks. Oh, a med
I like
kit,
how,
a precious med kit.
Hey, wait a second. I like how Nick is dying and Coach is just popping jokes. Oh, yeah. Alright, ready for it? Ready for it? Kaboom! This way
ain't going that way. I almost made a necrophilia joke. Is that bad?
For Coach? No, I'm pretty sure it's par for the course for what we expect from Coach at this point.
Okay. Well, the coach knows that if a teammate dies, he loses a teammate, but he gains a plaything.
That's awful. That is such poor taste.
You told me it was okay.
I lied. It was not okay. This is a building we can go through. This
is
a terrible idea.
Oh, stairs. Stairs. Somebody tell me where to go, because I keep getting lost.
I'm just following
Dingo. Up the stairs. Oh, we're all doomed.
Ah, health. Sweet, precious health.
Alright, well, I was going to try and push my original topic of conversation through again, but at this point, I'm done.
No,
I'm just done.
Let's do it. Let's do it.
No,
I want to
no, it's
hear
too
it.
Late. No, it's too late now. It's too late. I'm over it.
I'm
and
helping.
Dead air. complete silence. Down here, by the way.
I don't know what to talk about now. Hey, look, guys, I made a necrophilia joke. I might as well sign off. I'm done.
Guys, yeah, you really can't go anywhere past that. That is, you peaked. Much like Coach in a mortician's office, you finished.
Oh, that's not fair. If you say that I'm wrong and then you go there.
I'm keeping with the theme here, okay? You lead, I'll follow.
That's what Coach said?
No. I'm thinking about Coach, the funeral home director. Put him in a jersey.
Put him in a what?
A jersey.
Put him in a jersey.
Why? I'm helping.
Well, I like it. It makes me feel weird. It's my coaching pods. My coaching glands. Your what?
I don't know about you, but I've got an eye formation going on in my pants right now.
Oh, that's terrible. It's so bad.
Football jokes. It's appropriate of the mod we're playing.
Oh, you... Okay. You just sniped that hunter with a grenade launcher. That was a thing.
Dingo, I throw the witch.
You did. All right, we're coming. We're coming.
She dead?
Oh, wait. Oh. You hit her with a grenade. She got really distracted.
Ow, you jerks.
What? I saved you from a witch. You're complaining?
No, I was thinking that was probably what the witch was thinking. Like, she wasn't even hurting her. She was just really distracted by the pretty lights.
So, even when zombified, still a woman.
Alright, is there anything else just really offensive that Jotsam can talk about, or have we reached trifecta at this point?
Wait, are you telling me that,
Dingo. Come grab this defib. Defib unit here.
Are you telling me that sexist jokes are equal to
necrophilia jokes?
Because I really don't think that's true.
To certain people, I'm sure.
Oh, well, to certain people, yeah, but, I mean... Are they watching this video?
Possibly.
I guess we'll find out after we post the video.
No. Or are they
there's
out?
No, there's no way. There's no
are
way.
Are they out burning braziers?
Well, technically, you could be, because a brazier, if you spell it B-R-A-Z-I-E-R, it's still something that can be, like, it's something that holds a fire.
Charger! It holds a fire.
Don't make me kill it. Don't make me kill it. Okay.
That's true. We really get. He needs to be last. the last vestige of hope before we let him fire that thing.
What?
He's carrying a grenade launcher.
It's the best close quarters weapon.
It does kill everything in close quarters. Now, watching it stumble the witch was amusing. I'll give you that.
Pretty colors.
She looked so bewildered. I mean, she looked genuinely confused when it exploded next to her.
What is love? Beep boop.
She's like, I was going to kill this guy, but I can't remember why I came in here.
Hey, I did the most damage to the witch, by the way.
The guy with the gun that literally shoots explosions did the most damage to an angry prepubescent girl. Yeah, you go ahead and put that in your resume, bro. Let me know how that works out.
Right, you do need to come get naked.
I'm not in the game yet, Mr. Hosting.
Yes. You know you come into the game first, and Rochelle is in the game before we were ever conceived.
Rochelle lives here. She was here all along. Alright, so we're playing this game on computer.
Personal information.
Well, they all know that. Have you guys ever... Did you remember that old show, Reboot? Where it had the people playing... Like, it was the people inside the computer, and every time the user would play a game, it would have this giant glowing square come down, and if the... user one, it would kill all of the computer people inside the game at the time. And so they were constantly trying to beat the computer, or beat the user player. And it just got worse from there as viruses came in, and one of the people got trapped in the web and it aged them by centuries or something.
I don't remember this show.
You don't remember that show? It was terrible CGI. How can you guys not remember Reboot?
Because I never watched it.
It was on Cartoon Network.
I didn't have Cartoon Network.
Oh, you poor child.
Yeah, for most of my childhood, I did not have Cartoon Network.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well,
I really
never
didn't.
Mind.
It was sad.
I understand. No, I was going to say that...
Don't make fun of my handicap.
I'm sorry. I apologize. Did you at least have Nickelodeon?
Yes, I did have Nickelodeon because I watched Tiny Toons.
Oh, that's okay then. See, this is what I'm talking about. This is the kind of things that I'm wondering. Do the survivors talk about this stuff while they're going through the zombie
so
apocalypse?
You brought up Reboot.
What
just
did you
so
watch when you were a
kid? That conversation.
I'm the only one having that conversation, so yes.
You're like one of the politicians record. In the presidential debate. They ask a question and they'll answer with the unrelated prepared statement. It's going
like
to
that,
come back to what they want to talk about.
What was that girl, Miss South Carolina, I think? Oh, hello, Hunter.
How did that hunter leap in this 3-foot room? How did that
magic.
Happen?
Very powerful calf muscles. very powerful low-hanging leaps.
Oh, jeez.
Anyway, there was a...
South Carolina
beauty,
or something.
There was a beauty pageant contestant who did something almost exactly like that, where they asked her a question and she just started spouting off the most random nonsense to try and relate it to everything that her handlers had told her to prepare to answer about. So, I mean, they said, why do you think, I'm trying to remember this precisely, but why do you think that most Americans can't locate the U.S. on a map?
Oh,
something
I
along
do
those
remember
lines.
That. Yeah, because that
and
went
she was,
viral afterwards.
Yeah, and she was like, because the genocide in Rwanda and women's rights and...
she hit and everything. Every topic.
She hit everything. Oh, there's a tank, by the way.
Oh, that's fun.
He's coming
oh,
in here.
Here he comes.
He's here.
Molly!
Oh, I'm trapped against a wall.
Please enjoy the Molly.
Well, at least I'll have a
hey,
warm death.
Zombie. Come back here, survivor. Die, survivor zombie. He will not die.
Kreslev, we're in here dying, dude. Kreslev, come back.
He dead.
Shooter.
Oh, we can't use that one every time. Come on.
Yeah, we'll start to sound like blood-sucking lawyers.
Thank you.
Heyo.
Better.
Yeah, Dingo brings out all the references. He spares no expense. Which is good because all
yeah,
the references
the dingo
are right up our alley.
But when the dingo breaks down, he doesn't eat the tourists.
This is fiddling forced.
That's what Coach said.
That's not a quote.
Your punishment. Oh, now I feel bad because you quickly rectified it with a good comeback.
You can give Rochelle pain pills. Can I give her enough for her to overdose?
Will it make her quiet?
Very, very
quiet. Hey, did we not go through the bowling
there's
alley?
There's an arcade here. Yeah, there's an arcade here. Come over here.
Look out now. Well, we usually go through the bowling alley. Did we skip it?
Yeah, the bowling alley's right here.
We just haven't gone through it yet. Okay, cool.
Yeah.
My bowl.
Neat. I was extremely disappointed.
You can bowl, actually.
It doesn't
very exciting.
Go great. Well, look at
it
this
goes
sign.
Perfectly.
Bowl or else.
Watch, if you shoot the ball, it will roll. Oh, gutter. Gutter ball. Alright.
Haha, I strike.
Go get rid of these.
Yay.
Oh, wow. It takes a remarkable amount of ammo to get a strike. Ah, oh, everything's knocked down now. Okay, we're done with this place.
I'm bored. Much like regular bowling, it's fun for approximately 13 seconds.
Rochelle, what are you doing?
Yeah, once you walk in, you put on the cool shoes, and then you roll your first gutter ball, and you're like, okay, I'm done.
You don't.
This was a great birthday party, Jimmy.
You don't use the bumpers? No. What a nub.
No, pulling out the bumpers takes me immediately to the feeling horrible about myself.
I forget how to get out of here. Oh, the exit's over here.
Take the thing.
Yeah, I would go with the exit sign. Ooh, golf club.
So much sarcasm.
What gear? No.
Not a mine,
guys. Hunter. What is this word of which you speak? I have no knowledge of this place.
This sarcasm.
Hey, Ed, what's Fred Chile mean?
Reload.
Beep boop, what is love?
Baby, don't hurt me.
Beep boop.
I'm a reload.
Okay, computer, quit telling me to kill Rochelle with pain pills. She's not that bad.
Is that a movie theater?
Oh, she's dead.
Something bad just happened.
Oh, that's great. There's actually a defib over here. Rochelle, I'm here to help.
Wait,
Coach, get
wait
away
till
from
Coach
her body.
Is done. Wait till Coach is
Coach,
done.
Coach, what are you doing? Get away from there.
What are you guys doing out there?
Rochelle's awake and sticky.
You miss some stuff, Kreslev. You miss some stuff.
Yeah, some stuff and things. I love these movie names that they made.
Unforeseen consequences.
They did a really good job with this theater.
Yeah, the theater's great. Also, they took the Atlas from Dead Air, and they give him a... Oh, that's a witch.
Jeez. There's no explosive to help you that time.
You keep startling prepubescent girls.
Ooh. Fountain drinks. I love fountain soft drinks. I know they give me cancer, but I love them.
Only the diet ones.
Ugh. Oh, don't mention diet ones. Those are nasty.
Says you. I love diet.
You ruined my perfect fantasy about swimming in fountain drinks.
That just seems like it'd be sticky and uncomfortable.
It would be sticky. As
not,
sticky as Rochelle was a few minutes ago.
Oh, that's horrible. Not diet. There's no sugar in diet, so you won't get sticky.
Yeah, there's not sugar in it. There's a
super
terrible
low
taunt surface in it.
This isn't soda. This is a lie.
The soda is a lie. Like the cake.
Oh, there's a Portal reference. Okay. Should we start getting into...
Oh, wait. Isn't this the one where I found a way to get into, the projector room? Yeah, I did.
Don't
I found
do
a way
that.
Into
yeah.
the projector room. How did I
don't
do
that?
That?
It was in the theater, but it took forever, and you got lost, and then you were trying to figure out where you were and what you were doing.
It was cool. It was cool.
I think you and I have wildly differing ideas on what is cool.
Oh, now who's antagonistic?
Bow ties. Bow ties.
I just
said
we're wildly differing. Bow ties are not cool. Stop trying to make Doctor Who cool. Doctor Who is not cool.
Oh, a lot of people are going to disagree with you on that one.
And a lot of people
lot
are horrible
people.
Nerds.
Here we go again. You know, you once told... This is a verbatim quote from you to me that you said one time, and I'm going to share it.
Okay.
Do you want to hear it?
Yeah,
you
go
said,
for it.
I am an unconventional D&D player. That was a nerdy statement. For one thing, not only
well,
having played it enough to know what's unconventional, but then you claim that as an identity.
By unconventional, I mean I don't wear pants.
Still, still.
Much like Coach in a mortuary.
Of course, I seem to remember a certain quote from last game that said... That was you discussing the relationship status of Mystique.
Oh yeah, Romaine.
Well, no,
you were talking about
Rebecca Romaine Samus.
Yeah, you were talking about her ability to sustain relationships.
That's a valid concern.
That is a valid concern for a nerd, sir.
Yeah, but I'm not a horrible nerd. I'm just, kind of a bad nerd.
But here's the thing, we're right there with you. We all have the nerd tendencies, but you still demonize the demographic.
Of course. I have to be the alpha nerd, and the only way to do that is to make all the other nerds to hurt their little feelings.
This gun's not placed right at all.
I just want to take a second out of our horrible nerd bashing to say I actually really enjoy this set piece. I think this is a cool set piece. I kind of wish that the train would start rolling really slowly first.
I would agree with that. Because I agree with you. I think this is a really neat idea.
All right. Well, I guess since we're at this is the finale, right?
No, this is not the finale. No,
we gotta go through the football stadium, pal.
The train just starts running. Like, it just starts going really quick. Oh, I'm being healed by Jotsam.
Well, you're about to fall over. I mean, Rochelle is firing like a madman. Spitters are spitting everywhere, and you had one health.
But at least I had my morals.
Unlike Coach in a mortuary.
He has his morals, they're just really relaxed.
Oh, let's talk about moral relativity.
I'm just looking for some good old fashioned cola. None in
what
here.
Does that mean?
Better keep
in
looking.
What does it mean in that context? I'm not entirely sure.
Why are we leaving the train? The train is still good.
I'm still watching it load.
Yeah, I'm staring at a screen.
That tells me I killed very few with melee weapons.
This is the finale, by the way.
It is the final finale. That makes me think about Arrested Development.
Nerd.
But where did the lighter fluid come from?
Yeah, you should really watch it. You would like it.
I'm so broke. I can't even afford
it. It's on Netflix.
I know, I'm so broke, I can't even afford
Netflix. Oh, that's
right,
you don't have
really.
Netflix. You don't have Netflix. But you have cable. Explain that.
I do not. I have like 6 channels.
Are we ready?
Whenever I lost my job a couple months ago, we shut down everything. So I have literally like 8 channels on my TV right now.
I respect that. A lot of people keep their cable on indefinitely.
Nope.
I respect that.
The only thing that for us is an absolute, like, we cannot get rid of it is the internet.
Well,
internet is an absolute need.
That's pretty much a common carrier now, like a telephone or power.
Oh, because without the internet, I mean, how are you supposed to survive, honestly?
Yeah.
No, I 100% mean that. Like, I'm not being facetious. I'm
not either. I'm really not. Like, if people expect you to have it.
You know what got really disappointing for me, or what was really embarrassing the other day? I went to a job fair, and I'm not going to say where because that would give away my general location. But I went to a job fair.
Who's watching would be like, "Let's go," and he would get his bag together.
We've got it triangulated. Move out.
No, please continue.
Anyway, so it was at a local community college where they had a job fair, and I went there and I met these people, and I'm not going to say their name because there's no free rides. they're not getting free advertising. But basically what they do is you have to make a video interview for a position that you want, and then they forward
phone finger,
you know, all these. They forward all these video interviews, or at least the ones that match the criteria, to the company. It's a really interesting system, and it's really different because the people get to see you, you know, they get to see a person in an interview style setting before they ever even look at a resume, so they can kind of weed out the weirdos.
Did you show them your extra teeth?
Yeah, I did. And that's why I didn't get the job. Okay. We're not hiring him. He's part shark. But, so anyway, the girl that was there, who was telling me about the program, she was giving me business cards. And she's like, yeah, and whatever area of business you want to try and apply for, let's say you want to do engineering or accounting, you use your smartphone and you scan these certain QR codes and it'll take you right to that job listing. And she goes, yeah, so just, you know, here, I'll show you, pull out your smartphone. And I had to sit there and look at her for a second in abject misery and be like, I don't have a smartphone. And it was just this really awkward moment of she just gave me this look of pure pity. It's like, oh, you poor
you
man child.
Dying.
It's like, I didn't realize your situation was that dire. It was so embarrassing. That was so bad.
Okay, I don't have one either. It's okay.
Oh, that was painful. That was painful to remember.
I do want to point out, which Kreslev already has one, the palm finger melee weapon.
Yes.
Which he has strapped to his back, which apparently is a good place to keep a palm finger.
That's not where you keep a palm finger?
No, I actually keep it on my hand at all times. I'm wearing one right now.
When he clicks hard.
I do. I do want to give props to the developer of this as far as really
props,
really capturing the look and feel of a sports stadium, particularly a football stadium, because this is next to identical to one that I attend that I will not say which one it is, because I also don't want that guy putting a bag in his van and coming to visit me. So, but they did a really, really good job with it. I think this is one of the more convincing levels I've seen on a user-created mod. I haven't seen a bathroom
time,
yet,
guys.
But if we go in and it has like the, if we go into a bathroom and it has the, what is it called? Trough, the peeing trough, where there's no walls or anything, then they'll really have captured the feeling of a...
Ow, I'm hunted.
Oh, you're dying. I saved you. Somebody's taking their mic off. What happened? Oh, jeez, Boomer. Dingo just went idle.
Dingo went idle?
He did
oh,
go
that's
idle.
Not good.
I'm thinking he may have had to step away briefly.
Well, I guess the time then comes, Jotsam. What do you think of Suicide Blitz?
You know, I wish they had taken a bit more of it. Oh, jeez, I got you. I wish they'd taken a bit more of it and made it football-related. Like, this last level is, but I would have liked to see a little bit more. Because there's other things they could explore, like training facilities and stuff like that. If we're supposing this is an athletic facility for something like a college, then they would have, you know, that would open up tons of stuff that you could do. You could have made it college football-themed, gone through a university, gone through the athletic facilities, the pools, all that stuff. It could have been extra stuff put in there. Not the whole thing, you know, you don't have to do the whole thing, but I get a little bit annoyed when a user-created mod is themed a certain way, like this one is as far as football, and then you don't see any of that until you get to the very last level.
Two medkits over here.
And there's quite a few of them like that. I see them.
Johnson, you need...
Oh, I think they're gone.
Come here.
Yeah, I'm in need. Dingo, are you back?
Yeah, I'm back. I'm sorry, I had some weird connection issues. I get what you're saying, but at the same time, this campaign is stupid long.
Yeah, it is really long.
Wow.
Well, Tank is wearing his jersey.
Yeah,
yes,
it's Football Tank.
Football Tank. Football Tank. Look at his tiny helmet. His helmet is tiny. It's adorable.
Oh,
someone killed him.
Oh, Football Tank behind us as well. Football Tank behind us. Keep moving.
Come on, Football Tank.
I've already got him on fire, by the way.
There's also humongous footballs.
Nice shot, Football Tank.
One tank is dead. That must have been
another tank. Hey, look, there's a football. I shot it. I shot the football. Now, I don't know if this is a college or an NFL stadium.
Tank's down.
Let's find a football and see which regulation size it is.
They're humongous.
Oh, what are we doing now?
NFL footballs are long, and NCAA footballs are thicker, you know, wider girth.
Whoa.
Oh, here's one.
We're talking about anymore.
NFL. This is an NFL stadium. I'm assuming this is a realistic representation of the footballs.
Did somebody say football?
Maybe this is my form of the gun details, because I know very little about guns, but I know football sizes.
Figure out how this got here.
Well, I was getting charged. Is that okay?
No, that's not okay.
I think it's silly to put guns right here at the end.
Says you.
Well, it's like, hey, did you need some guns?
Hey, there's three helicopters here.
You should have thought about that before you left. Like that guy who's triangulating our position.
As we speak.
Kreslev!
Come on, Dingo.
Let
Johnson.
It be, let it be.
What are you doing?
I'm hopping. Can't you see skipping jubilation?
You say the tank is that chases
tank?
You down.
That, that is definitely more tanks.
Ah, Jackie!
Come on, Jotsam.
Let it be, let it be.
All right, to prevent this from being really long, we should go ahead and do final thoughts.
Yeah,
Jotsam's already done his.
I already did mine. So
Kreslev, final thoughts.
I thought it was really good. I enjoyed it. It was very varied. It was a lot of different things, which I enjoy. I always enjoy a very varied campaign. It helps you kind of get through, you know, different levels, and it's very visually interesting. And I think playthrough-wise, it makes it more interesting. So, I mean, overall, I definitely recommend it for a download. It was a longer campaign, but it wasn't impossible. He did a good job of making sure that there was rest points in the longer levels.
Look at the first aid kits. You guys suck them down like a rogue child who's found candy.
I just was trying to keep them from Rochelle. And honestly, with you, with Coach around, with you being Coach, did I really dare die?
Maybe he's just motivating his teammates to live.
Yeah, all right, I don't want my corpse desecrated.
All right, Dingo, your thoughts?
It's a very visually.
Oh yeah, I just want to point out. Yes, I used double the amount of med kits as Jotsam, but I also killed double the infected.
Maybe it's because I was weak. I was exhausted. Anyway, go ahead.
Okay, I was gonna say it was a very visually interesting and varied campaign. I understand what you were saying, Jotsam, about, you know, wishing that they would have thrown in a few more things that would have been a little different. I feel like if they had removed the sewer level and instead put in the locker room or something like that, it would have been a little better.
Mm-hmm.
But you definitely get a sense of traveling. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's true.
You start off in the apartment building, and you know, you go from there. It's very cool. Yeah, you know, you go through the apartment building, the city. You really feel like you're traveling instead of just in the one local area.
I like the bowling alley.
I like the bowling alley too. That was cool. A lot of the really neat little side areas. The bowling alley, the movie theater.
Yeah.
Just neat little things. It could definitely use some tweaking. It is long, but it does have a lot of stuff in it. Overall, I liked it. They can't what? Call him Coach? Yeah. They can't call him anything because they're dead.
Now he's explaining jokes.
Yeah, me. Anyway, I'm explaining jokes. That's what I'm doing. That's what I'm here for, is to explain the jokes, right? Because that makes jokes funny, is when you explain them. If somebody doesn't explain the jokes, how are you supposed to get them, Jotsam? That's all I can do, is explain the jokes. I mean, that's...
All right.
This seems like a good time to sign off.
Is that your thoughts, or...?
Yes, that is my thoughts. Also, stay away from Coach.
All right, so So if you like the video, be sure to subscribe, and if you have time, pop over to our Facebook page, give that a like. We also have a Twitter account, so you could like that as well if for some strange reason you tweet.
Bunch of twitties.
We don't, but you can follow us.
Also,
you could subscribe to the tweets, but nothing will be on there ever.
Hey, we post when we have new videos up on our Twitter account.
Okay.
And If you have an idea for a mod or a user-created level you would like us to try out, be sure to leave it in the comments below. Or if you're watching us on Something Awful, be sure to leave it in that thread. So, for Grizzled Beagle Playthroughs, this is Kreslev.
This is Dookie Dingo.
And this is Jotsam.
We hope you guys had as much fun watching as we had playing.
Watch out for Coach.